lived in downtown Phoenix and large metropolitan areas, and the reason why we chose Buckingham is because we wanted to get away from everything. We wanted to be out where we had fresh air, we could see the stars, and you know, we could grow our own food that we knew that it wasn't contaminated with pesticides and other issues. So when we bought out here, I didn't even have a job. I knew that I could work wherever I needed to, you know, as a nurse. I drive an hour, but I like that because I can come here and get away from everything. So, everything, you know, it's all in perspective. Those that don't live very close to it probably don't think anything of it. But if it was right at their back door, they would. It's really hard to see other people that are feeling the same way you are because they're just not in the same position. And they feel like it doesn't affect them or they can't do anything. And I really feel like this coming this close to us, it's just going to be on right on the property behind us. They're not doing eminent domain on us, but you know, we have a stream that runs off our property. You know, it's not going to be pleasant. We hear the windmill from where we are, and we're happy with that. And on a nice clear day, we can hear the train, which is 4 miles away. I can't imagine what this pressurization is going to sound like because it's even closer. So I hope that we can do something to make it not be here. You know, I don't really want it. I really feel like we, as a nation, can do other things. Badly for anyone whose property is just being taken by eminent domain. That's just a terrible, terrible thing. It's not fair. No matter who you are, where you are, you become passionate about something when it affects you. So. Thank you.
Thank you. One. Well, they made up their minds to be everywhere because why not? Everywhere was theirs, because they thought so. They with two leaves, they whom the birds despise. In the middle of stones, they made up their minds. They started to cut. Well, they cut everything, because why not? Everything was theirs because they thought so. It fell into shadows, and they took both away. Some to have, some for burning. Well, cutting everything, like the others, the last one fell into its shadow. It fell into its shadow on the water. They took it away. Its shadow stayed on the water. Well, they shrugged. They started trying to get the shadow away. They cut right to the ground. The shadow stayed full. They laid boards on it. The shadow came out on top. They shone lights on it. The shadow got blacker and clearer. They exploded the water. The shadow rocked. They built a huge fire on the roots. They sent up black smoke between the shadow and the sun. The new shadow flowed without changing the old one. They shrugged. They went away to get stones. They came back. The shadow was growing. They started setting up stones. It was growing. They looked the other way. It went on growing. They decided they would make a stone out of it. They took stones to the water. They poured them into the shadow. Thank you. The shadow was not filled. It went on growing. That was one day. The next day was just the same. It went on growing. They did all the same things. It was just the same. They decided to take its water from under it. They took away water. They took it away. The water went down. The shadow stayed where it was before. It went on growing. It grew onto the land. They started to scrape the shadow with machines. When it touched the machines, it stayed on them. That was another day. Well, the next day started about the same, went on growing. They pushed lights into the shadow. Where the shadow got onto them, they went out. They began to stomp on the edge. It got their feet. And when it got their feet, they fell down. It got into eyes. The eyes went blind. The ones that fell down, it grew over, and they vanished. The ones that went blind and walked into it vanished. The ones that could see and stood still, it swallowed their shadows. Then it swallowed them too, and they vanished. Well, the others ran. The ones that were left went away to live if it would let them. They went as far as they could, the lucky ones with their shadows. That was by W.S. Merwin.
Very good.
Thank you.
I'm in the valley, you're gonna reap just what you sow.
If you've been fracking, better quit your fracking. If you've been fracking, better quit your fracking.
Drink it in the valley.